Hello everybody, today we are going to see some converse of theorems. Okay, already we have seen those theorems, now we are going to see converse of each theorem. Okay, so see here, we have seen this is theorem number this one. In a parallelogram, opposite sides are equal. In a parallelogram, opposite sides are equal. Means here, parallelogram was given. And we have to prove opposite sides are equal of that parallel. Okay. But what is the converse of this theorem? See, statement is given. A quadrilateral is a parallelogram if opposite sides are equal. If its opposite sides are equal. Here, opposite sides are equal. That was given. But here, we have to prove. Here, it was given in a parallelogram, opposite sides are equal. Parallelogram was given. And here, we have to prove. The quadrilateral, the given quadrilateral is a parallelogram. So that this statement is the converse of this theorem. Already we have seen this theorem. Now we are going to prove the converse of the same theorem. Okay. So the procedure is same. What is given here? Given a quadrilateral is a parallelogram. Quadrilateral is given ABCD. Okay. A quadrilateral is a parallelogram. Quadrilateral ABCD. In which what is given? Opposite sides are equal. Opposite sides are equal. AB is equal to CD. In which AB is equal to CD and AD is equal to BC. AD is equal to BC. This is given. Okay. Now what we have to prove? The quadrilateral is a parallelogram. We have to prove this ABCD is a parallelogram. Okay. So to prove quadrilateral ABCD is a parallelogram. Okay, this is a parallelogram that we have to prove. Okay, with the help of given things. Now directly we cannot give proof, so we need to do some construction. So this we will take one diagonal either AC or DB. Okay, so join A and C. Okay, join AC, that is construction, so that also we need to mention construction, join A and C, join A and C or join AC. Okay, so due to diagonal AC, this given quadrilateral is divided into two triangles. Okay, which triangle? ACD and triangle CAB. Okay, ACD and CAB, two triangles are there. Okay, so now what we are going to prove, we have to prove this is a parallelogram. This is a parallelogram. Okay, so we first initially we need to show both the triangles are congruent. Okay, we will show these two triangles are congruent. So we can use directly here proof in triangle ACD and triangle. ACD and triangle CAB, two triangles are given. Okay, what is given in that? AB is equal to CD, AD is equal to BC, and AC is the third side of both the triangles, and that is common. Okay, so we can mention directly here AC is equal to AC, then AB is equal to CD, AB is equal to CD, this is common side. This is given and next AD is equal to BC. Okay, this is also given. So with the help of these three things, we can say both the triangles are congruent by side, because three sides are given. Okay, three sides of this triangle ACD are equal or congruent to the three sides of the corresponding triangle, that is triangle CA. So we can say triangle ACD congruent triangle CAB by side by SSS product congruence. Okay, now we have given here proof this both the triangles are congruent. Okay, so now we can say here angle DAC, this angle angle BAC is equal to angle ACD. ACD. Why? Corresponding angles. Okay, corresponding. So here we can write angle BAC. BAC is equal to angle ACB. ACB. Why? By CPC. CPC. Okay, corresponding part of congruent angle. Both the triangles are congruent. So these are the corresponding angles. So by CPCT, both the triangle, both the angles are congruent. As well as we can say this angle. Angle BCA or ACD, angle ACD is equal to ACD is equal to CAB. Angle CAB. Angle CAB. The result is same by CPC. Corresponding part of congruent angle. And these are the corresponding angles. Corresponding angles. Okay. So this is, I am saying this is first one and this is second one. Okay. Now, got it everybody? This angle is equal to this, that is DAC. DAC is equal to ACD. Okay. Then ACD is equal to CA. Okay. What is our target? We have to prove this quadrilateral is a parallelogram. Okay, parallelogram is what? Opposite sides are parallel to each other. Okay, sides are equal, that is given. That is one thing. And we need to prove opposite sides are parallel to each other. Okay, so that we are trying to prove here. Okay, so now after this, see, now CD and AB, we don't know still both the lines are parallel to each other. Okay, but AC, transversal AC, transversal AC, transversal AC cuts to the line CD and AB at point A and C. Okay, cuts to the points C and A respectively. Okay, to the lines BC and E. BC and E. Okay, AC is a working as a transversal. Now these two lines, AC cuts to line BC and AB at point A and C. Okay, so now but here what is given? We know the when two lines are parallel and it cut by a transversal, that time alternate interior angles are equal. Okay, but here BAC is equal to ACB. BAC is equal to ACB. This and this angle is equal. Okay. And both angles are alternate angles of each other. Also, here these two angles, this and this angle is also equal. And both angles are alternate interior angles of each other. Understood? So now we can see here if these two angles, that is CAB is equal to ACD. Okay, angle CAB is equal to angle CAB is equal to ACD. Angle ACD. Okay, why? From 1. Okay, and both angles. Are alternate interior angles of each other. Okay, if alternate interior angles are equal, then we can say CD is parallel to AB. CD is parallel to AB. So this is third one. Okay, second thing, we have CAB. Okay, the angle DAC, is equal to angle AC. DAC is this angle, is equal to AC, this angle. Okay, here, why we have said this? From second, it is given, we have given here. Okay, so DAC is equal to angle AC. Okay, so this is second one. But these both angles are alternate angles also. Angles also. And both are equal. Okay. Interior angles and both angles are same. So we can say AD is equal to BC. AD is parallel to BC. AD is parallel to BC. So this is I am saying four. Okay. Here third one is CD is parallel to AB. CD is parallel to AB. Okay. One pair of opposite side is parallel to each other. Second, AD is parallel to BC. AD is parallel to BC. So that another pair of opposite side is also parallel. So according to the property of parallelogram, opposite sides are parallel to each other. Okay. So we can say finally we can say quadrilateral ABCD is a parallelogram. Okay. From third and fourth. From third and fourth. Quadrilateral ABCD is a parallelogram. Okay. So this is the converse of this theorem. In a parallelogram, opposite sides are equal and this is its converse. Okay, so any question can come in the exam. So accordingly we need to give the proof. Okay. Okay, see here our second theorem is theorem number 3. The opposite angles of parallelograms are equal. Okay, already we have seen this theorem. Now we are going to see its converse. Okay, the statement is the opposite angles of a parallelogram are equal. This is the original theorem. Okay, and its converse is a quadrilateral is a parallelogram if its opposite angles are equal. If its opposite angles are equal. Okay, here it was given the opposite angles of parallelogram are equal. Means here it was given that quadrilateral is parallelogram, which is given. Understood? Quadrilateral is parallelogram. But here we have to prove that the given quadrilateral is a parallelogram. But one thing is given, the quadrilateral is a parallelogram if its opposite angles are equal. Here opposite angles are equal. Means angle B is equal to angle D and angle A is equal to angle C. Okay, so that is given. So first we will mention quadrilateral ABCD in which angle A is equal to angle C and angle B is equal to angle D. Okay, so this is given. Now we have to prove that quadrilateral is a parallel. ABCD is a parallelogram. That we have to prove. So to prove quadrilateral ABCD is a parallelogram. Quadrilateral ABCD is a parallelogram. Okay, that we have to prove. Now in proof we will see. A plus B, suppose we will add these two angles, consecutive angles, angle A plus B, or we can take A plus D also. A plus B is equal to C plus D. Okay, or we can mention first here angle A is equal to angle C and angle B is equal to angle B. Okay, why? Both the things are given. These things are given. Okay, so angle A plus B. Angle A plus angle B is equal to angle C plus angle D. Okay, if you will add this A plus B, then C plus D. Sum of this both angle is equal to C plus D. So this we can say this is first one. Okay, these things are given. Angle A plus B. A plus B is equal to C plus D. Okay, so anyhow we can do A plus B. A plus B, instead of A plus B, we can take A plus D is equal to B plus C. Anyhow, we can take. Okay? So, A plus B is equal to C plus B. Now, we will use here angle sub property of quadrilateral. Okay? Angle sub property of quadrilateral, that is angle A plus angle B plus angle C plus angle D is equal to 360 degree. Okay? Angle sub property. Angle sub property of quadrilateral. Okay, so angle A plus B plus C plus D, if you put here bracket angle A plus B and here angle C plus D. But we know angle A plus B is equal to angle C plus D. So C plus D we can replace by angle A plus B. Angle A plus angle B. Or angle A plus angle B we can replace by angle C plus D. Getting very quick because the sum of these two angles is equal to the sum of C plus D. Okay, so angle A plus B, angle A plus angle B plus C plus D we will replace by again angle A plus angle B equals to 360 degree. Okay, so this is from 1. Okay, now angle A plus angle A, 2 times angle A plus 2 times angle B. So directly we can take 2 times angle A plus angle B is equal to 360 degree. So angle A plus angle B is equal to 360 divided by 2 is 180. 360 divided by 2 is 180. So this is I am saying here second. Angle A plus B is what? 360 degree, 180 degree. Angle A plus B is 180. Okay. So angle A plus B 180 degree, and these are the consecutive interior angles. Okay. Sum of interior angle is 180 degree. Okay. So after this we can write sum of interior angles is 180 degree. Interior angles, angle A plus B is equal to 180 degree. So we can say AD is parallel to BC. From this we can say AD is parallel to BC because sum of these two angles is 180 degree. Okay, so this is I am saying here third one. Okay, now we know that angle A plus angle B, angle A plus angle B is equal to 180 degree. Okay, from this is from second or this is directly we have taken second one. But angle A is equal to angle C. Angle A and angle C are equal. So this angle I am replacing by angle C. Angle C plus angle B is equal to 180 degree. Okay, here reason if you want you can write angle A is equal to angle C. This reason we can give. Angle C plus B is equal to 180 degree. Okay, so interior, sum of interior angle is 180 degree again here. Sum of interior angle is 180 degree. Okay. And here BC is transversal. BC is a transversal. BC is transversal. BC is transversal. Okay, and CD it cuts. CD and AB at point B and C. B and C here. And B plus C is equal to 180 degree. Okay. B plus sum of interior angle is sum of interior angles is 180 degree. Sum of interior angles is 180 degree. Okay. So this is working as a transversal. These two lines are there. And sum is 180 degree. So from this we can say AB is parallel to CD. AB is parallel to CD. So this is I am saying fourth one. Okay. Here AD is parallel to BC. AD is parallel to BC because AB is a line, is a transversal. It cut to AD and BC at point A and B. Okay, so, and sum of interior angle is 180 degree. So from that we have said, we said here AD is parallel to BC, and here we got AB is parallel to CD. First one, AB is parallel to BC. One pair of opposite side is parallel. Second thing we got, AB is parallel to CD. Second pair, AB is parallel to CD. So both the pair of opposite sides are parallel to each other. So from this third and fourth we can say quadrilateral ABCD is a parallelogram. Okay, so here we can write from third and fourth. From third and fourth, we can see here quadrilateral ABCD is a parallelogram. Okay,